Right, here's the bedroom. We've got some electric fields coming out of this wall here, which we're going to address today. And also the two side walls as well. This is a short one with the archway. We're just going to paint that before the archway. And on the other side of the wall, on the other side of the room, we're going to paint that wall as well. We've got the meter box on the other side, so the paint is going to help stop the electric fields coming through. And if I ever do get one of those smart meters, it will help to reduce the amount of microwave radiation coming through as well. Switch that on. And as you can see, it's not dramatically high, but it's running around 50 or 60 watts per meter, so volts per meter. And that's the sort of stuff we're sleeping in, which, you know, ain't a good thing to have. So hopefully once I've got the paint on there, it'll come down a fair bit. Three things. The first thing we need is, of course, the Y-Shield paint. But the paint on its own ain't going to do it, because you need to ground the wall so that the radiation can run off into the ground. Secondly, what's required is conductive tape, which is also available through Y-Shield. And this runs around the edge of the wall and it collects the radiation. And this is the third thing you'll need. It's a metal plate, also available from Y-Shield, which needs to screw into the wall over the top of the conductive tape, and then the wire runs the radiation off in one of two ways. You can either run it off into an earth stake, which would be outside, run it through the floorboards or through the wall or through the window. The second way is you can attach one of these. These are a couple of bucks each from Bunnings. Probably need to get an electrician to do this without getting into trouble, but all you need is the one wire which connects to the earth plug, and that will effectively run off the radiation as well. That's what I'm doing with my wall today. Okay, just on this wall, I mentioned that the meter box was on the other side of the wall behind the dresser. I'll just take you outside and show you the issue with that. This is our front door. And go down the steps here. And back up. There's the window to our bedroom. And here's our meter box. And as you can see, I've let our power company know. I've been in conversation with them. There's no way in the world of putting in a smart meter here. But I'm going to paint that wall anyway. Because if you look over the fence here, there it is. That's the next door neighbor's meter box just over my fence. And it's a pretty dodgy looking one, but if they ever get a smart meter in there, from everything I've heard, they pulse every 5 minutes or so fairly high levels of radio frequency EMR, which ain't really a good thing. Okay, I've sort of prepared the wall a bit, got some masking tape around the edges, and we've actually got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 power points all together along this wall. So I don't know what the builder was thinking. A couple of electric clocks and maybe an electric blanket. Not sure what the other three outlets are for, but must have some serious electrical equipment in their bedroom. So this black patch here, you need to paint below where you're going to place, where is it, the metal plate. And I'd strongly suggest that if you're going to do all this yourself, I'm not sure if it's legal or not, but I have, if you're going to wire this up to the earth plug, you need to get yourself one of these. This is a grounding tester, and they're pretty cheap. You can get them on the internet. And if the two green lights come on, that means that your electricity supply is grounded correctly. So, and as you can see, it's fine here. I've got the two green lights happening, so it means if I plug this thing here in, I'm not going to get zapped. So just unplug that. Okay, there we go. We've just done the screwed in the wall plate, and that's actually plugged into the wall as well, and it's all working. You don't need to have this switch on for the earthing to work, so you might as well leave that off if you're going to do it this way. And just one more point, just as a safety thing, with the conductive tape or even with the black paint, just leave a 1 or 2 centimeter gap around any power points that you're working around or any light switches, just a safety thing, because this the carbon paint and the tape obviously is all conductive, so you might as well keep it a little bit of a distance between that and any electrical work. And with a conductive tape, you'll see that it's spread it right along the wall there. Don't worry too much if it's not parallel with the skirting board or with the corners. Once you get a few coats of paint on there, you'll hardly see it unless you look really close. I did muck up a bit here. I should have really put that the plate down lower below the power point so I could run one piece of tape right the way through. But the way I've done it, the way I've dodged it up, is going to work fine. As long as any tape overlaps that you're using, the conductivity will continue through. Also, in a couple of the corners, I put tape up the wall. Not all the way up. I'm not going to paint right to the ceiling. This paint's expensive, and it's just not worth doing. I'm only going to paint probably 3/4 of the way up the wall. And if you get the tape maybe 2/3 of the way up the wall, that'll help collect any electrical fields that are there and send them on down to the plate and out through the earth. So just done one in the other corner, one in this corner. And once I get around to shifting this dresser, I'll probably put another one in that corner over there before I paint that wall. So it's all ready to paint now. Okay, I'm about to open the can of paint. Bit different to a normal can. This one you don't stir. This one you've got to shake gently for a minute or so.
Another 20 seconds.
Okay, I'm ready to start painting now. As you can see, I've prepped all the corners. I've just paintbrushed around all the cornices and all the hard bits to get to with the roller. If you have a look at this wall over here, I'm actually going to go right to the ceiling with that wall because we've got the smart meter issues on the other side of the wall and over the fence. So to give some more protection, we'll do the whole wall with the black paint. Result. There we go. Lovely black colour all the way around this wall and this one. You see it almost up to the ceiling. And now all I've got left is to cover that black paint. And here's the finished product. I've got 2 coats of the Y Shield paint on. I've got, I think from memory, 5 coats of our new white paint. And that's the finished product, and now we just got to check to see what sort of impact we've had with the Y Shield. Okay, so here we go. This is roughly where we took the readings from earlier on. You hear it ticking a little bit, so it's running at around the 5, between 5 and 10, so that's a pretty good result. I think it was running on around 50 to 70 before we put the paint on. So now it's a fairly comfortable, well under 10 volts per meter.